Let's start with basic characteristics of a mechanical wave. When we talk about a mechanical wave, we can say a mechanical wave character is defined by three basic characteristic properties. These are, the first one is amplitude of wave. Second is frequency of wave. And the third one is velocity of wave. All these three we'll discuss in detail. But first we'll talk about the wave generation. Say, if we are having a wave source, actually a wave source is nothing, it is just an oscillator. An oscillator one oscillates and its oscillations are in contact with a physical medium, particle medium, particles also oscillate and carry energy from oscillator to other places. Like if we talk about a unidirectional wave, in case of unidirectional wave, the energy from the oscillator propagates in a single direction. In later part of this topic, we are going to study about different directional wave or multidirectional waves also. But just to understand how the wave is propagated, let's consider the oscillator is oscillating and the medium particles which are in contact with the oscillator will also oscillate. And due to contact of these particles with the next layer of particle, these will transfer energy to the next layer of particles and so on. This is the way how the energy from oscillator propagates. Here we can say physical medium particles act as wave carrier. Actually, wave is carried away from the wave source or oscillator to remote locations by the physical medium. That's why the medium or medium particles are taken as wave carriers. Let's discuss about these characteristics of a wave step by step in detail and the factors on which these properties of wave depends. Let's talk about amplitude of wave. As you already studied in the section of SHM and oscillations, that amplitude is basically maximum displacement of medium particles during their oscillations from mean position. So actually when we talk about amplitude of wave, it is defined for the medium particles which are carrying energy. So medium particles which transfer energy in wave when oscillate, the maximum displacement of these medium particles from mean position we define as amplitude. Like if there is an oscillator and it is supplying energy in a specific direction for a unidirectional wave, we can say the medium particle will oscillate. So its displacement curve would look like this, that medium particles are going up and down and the wave is propagating in forward direction. So medium particle which are oscillating up and down, back and forth, one after another, we can say for a lossless medium, or we can also talk about an ideal medium, the wave amplitude remains constant. That means the medium particle which is in the neighborhood of oscillator or it is located away from the oscillator, all will have same amplitude, all particles will oscillate with same amplitude, so it remains constant. When we talk about a lossy medium in which energy losses takes place, so what happens in the situation, oscillator produces the oscillation, but as wave propagates, the amplitude of oscillation decreases. Because we know that energy of oscillation is directly proportional to square of amplitude for a particle which is oscillating, and if some energy loss takes place, gradually the oscillation amplitude will decrease, energy has to decrease due to losses of energy. This energy losses we call damping. So, we can state in case of a lossless medium, amplitude of wave depends on oscillator, but in case of a lossy medium or in case of a damping situation, the amplitude depends on medium. So, here we can say A depends on wave source only. And in this situation, we can say A depends on characteristics of medium in which wave propagates. It all depends how much energy the medium absorbs. So, amplitude will damp quickly or it may last for a long duration. It all depends on the type of medium. The next characteristic is frequency of waves. As you are aware that frequency is number of oscillations of medium particles per unit time and it is measured in the units of hertz. So, the number of oscillations per second the particles will make is called frequency of medium particles and it is actually the frequency of waves. We can say when from a wave source, a wave is produced in a particular direction or in all directions, we can say as the energy is transferred due to one particle in contact with the other and then that particle in contact with the next particle. So, in this situation, the frequency of oscillation of all particles remains constant. It never changes. So, we can simply state that frequency of a wave only depends on wave source or the oscillator which is producing the wave. Wherever the wave is propagating, its frequency will always remain constant even if it will undergo some kind of phenomena like transmission, reflection, absorption. We can just keep in mind, say we are having a boundary of two media and you know that when a wave incident on a boundary which we call incident wave, after incident a part of it is bounced back into the same medium which we call reflected wave. A part is transmitted into the other medium which is called transmitted or refracted wave and a part may be absorbed by the medium. In this situation, we can say if the incident wave is having a frequency n0, after reflection, reflected wave frequency nr, transmitted wave frequency nt and the absorbed part frequency na, all will remain same. In any phenomena, the wave frequency never changes. Here we can say nr is equals to na is equals to nt is equals to n0. Actual frequency of wave always remain same. The medium particles oscillations are always at same rate if from a rigid medium boundary a wave is reflected. The last basic characteristic is the wave velocity. We can say it is the speed with which energy is transferred through the medium. The speed at which energy transfers through the medium is called wave speed or wave velocity. We can state that wave velocity mainly depends on the physical properties of medium in which the wave is propagating. That is basically we can state that is after generation, wave is carried by the medium. This implies its speed is decided by medium only. Mathematically, we'll also discuss in later sections of the topic how the speed is evaluated, but you should always keep that the speed at which the wave energy is being propagated depends only on medium. And at last, we can write down a note to summarize all the things that wave amplitude and frequency mainly depends on wave source and wave velocity depends on medium. In detail, we'll study that in some particular situation when wave amplitude becomes excessively high, wave velocity also start depending on amplitude. But that is beyond the scope of our topics which we are studying. In advanced physics section of physics galaxy, you'll study about how wave velocity also depends on amplitude. In this section, I'll be restricting myself up to this level only.